From Bunjilong Country, this is Sunday Mass with Bishop Greg Homeming.
Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the ascension of our Lord into heaven, and above all we give thanks to him for all that he does and continues to do for us. Let's acknowledge that sometimes we despair and fail to recognize his presence, and today above all else let's acknowledge that as we gather together. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ of mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who believe that your only begotten Son, our Redeemer, ascended this day to the heavens, may in spirit dwell already in heavenly realms. who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
In my earlier work, Theophilus, I dealt with everything Jesus had done and taught from the beginning until the day he gave his instructions to the apostles he had chosen through the Holy Spirit and was taken up to heaven. He had shown himself alive to them after his passion by many demonstrations. For 40 days he had continued to appear to them and tell them about the kingdom of God. When he had been at table with them, he had told them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for what the Father had promised. "It is," he had said, "what you have heard me speak about. John baptized with water, but you, not many days from now, will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." Now, having met together, they asked him, "Lord, has the time come? Are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" He replied, "It is not for you to know the times or dates that the Father has decided by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and then you will be my witnesses not only in Jerusalem, but throughout Judea and Samaria, and indeed to the ends of the earth." As he said this, he was lifted up while they looked on, and a cloud took him from their sight. They were still staring into the sky when suddenly two men in white were standing near them, and they said, "Why are you men from Galilee standing here looking into the sky? Jesus, who has been taken up to you from heaven into heaven, this same Jesus will come back in the same way as you have seen him go there." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, the blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, the blare of
cry to God with shouts of joy. For the Lord, the Most High, we must fear, great King over all the earth.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, the blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. Sing praise for God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, the blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God is King of all the earth. Sing praise with all your skill. God is King over the nations. God reigns on his holy throne.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
Second reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and perception of what is revealed, to bring you to the full knowledge of him. May he enlighten the eyes of your mind so that you can see what hope his call holds for you, what rich glories he has promised the saints will inherit, and how infinitely great is the power that he has exercised for us believers. This you can tell from the strength of his power at work in Christ, when he used it to raise him from the dead and to make him sit at his right hand in heaven, far above every sovereignty, authority, power, or domination, or any other name that can be named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. He has put all things under his feet and made him as the ruler of everything, the head of the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills the whole creation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you all.
The 11 disciples set out for Galilee to the mountain where Jesus had arranged to meet them. When they saw him, they fell down before him, though some hesitated. Jesus came up and spoke to them. He said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore, make disciples of all the nations, baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them to observe all the commands I gave you. And know that I am with you always, yes, to the end of time." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. About 35 years ago, I was a young Carmelite brother, and I was studying theology in Melbourne. And we finished our last moment, time of prayer was from 9 o'clock to 9:30 in the evening, after which we had the great silence, which meant that we didn't speak again until breakfast the next morning. But many of us, like myself, after the great silence began, would go to our rooms and continue studying. And I would generally continue studying until 11 o'clock. These days, I'm asleep by 11 o'clock, but in those days, I was still at my desk. And I would come down to the kitchen at about 11 o'clock and make a Milo with milk to help me sleep. Well, this evening, the student master, Father Ross, quite an extraordinary holy man, a man of great learning with a doctorate from Oxford University, came in, and I put my head down because we were in silence and didn't say a word to him. And he said to me when he'd made his Milo, "What have you been reading?" So I thought, he wants to talk. So I started telling him, and I was studying something in St. Thomas Aquinas, of all things, about angels. And I said to him, what I find very difficult is the claim that we are higher as human beings and more important than angels. And he said, "That's right." And I said, no, I can't accept that. So we sat down and talked until after midnight, so much for the great silence, about angels. And he started quoting for me from memory St. Paul, where St. Paul says, "We are higher than the angels, and the angels will one day worship us." In today's letter to the Ephesians, he also says that Jesus Christ is above the angels. And as the years have gone on, I've pondered, I've always had struggled for a long time, because at the end of our discussion, because I was falling asleep anyway, I was not convinced by what my student master had told me. But nevertheless, I continued to ponder it. Today's feast, the Feast of the Ascension, is the feast day that gives meaning to what I struggled with that evening with my student master. In today's gospel, Jesus says to us, "I will be with you always until the end of time." And yet, in a funny way, he was leaving, and they experienced his absence. What's the meaning, "I will be with you always until the end of time"? We need to look at what the Ascension is about. It's not an explanation, fundamentally, that to say, well, he was here and now he's gone, he's ascended into heaven. No, if that was the case, we wouldn't have a feast about it. That's rather trite. It's like saying Mary kind of put nappies on him. These are simple facts. He was here and he's not here now. What today's feast is about is he ascends to heaven, but he ascends to heaven not simply as God, but as a human being. And therefore, what it is to be human is taken to heaven in Jesus Christ in such a way that his humanity is now in the Godhead, is within the Trinity. But it's not simply his humanity, it's my humanity and your humanity. My humanity is what I have in common with Jesus, and my humanity is what enables me to have a direct line, a personal human relationship with him in such a way that he understands me before I open my mouth, because he is human like me. And when we say he ascended to heaven, he ascends to heaven as a human being and takes with him everything that we are except sin into the presence of God the Father, where that humanity remains for all eternity. That's not true of an angel. So I'm quite convinced now that what my student master tried to tell me that night 35 years ago, I know he was right. And yet way back then I didn't understand it. What I am is in Jesus Christ and is in the presence of God here and now. And in that sense, Jesus is with me always until the end of time, because I share what I am with Jesus and he shares his humanity with me. That is the most profound sharing. It's more than sharing a meal with someone. And when you share a meal with someone, you experience who they are and their goodness. But it's such that I can never be apart from Jesus Christ, because he will never be apart from me, because what I am is what he is. And therefore, that means that it changes for all of us. Today's feast day changes how we relate to God and to Jesus Christ. Everything that I am at every moment of my life is in the presence of God, because I'm human and he is human. I can't hide from him. I can't close the door here and say, well, keep away from me at this moment. I don't want you to know anything about what's happening now. No, because I am human. And everything about me is about Jesus Christ in this sense, which means that my prayer is my daily life, because my daily life is my relationship in my humanity with Jesus Christ. And everything then about me that I do and think and everything is in the presence of the living God here and now through Jesus Christ. And so, yes, we are above the angels, because I, not me personally, but my humanity is in the presence of God. And in that, Jesus pleads for me. He mediates who I am to the Father, not because I speak with him, but because I am at one with him in my humanity. Therein lies the call of the Christian life, to choose to bring my life into conformity with Jesus Christ. Not simply that I share the humanity, but that I take his humanity as the model and I make my life as it is now more like his. That's the challenge of the Ascension. That's what we are called to do.
Stand and profess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
When our risen Saviour ascended into heaven, angels reminded his disciples that he would come back again. Until he comes, we continue his work by praying for all peoples and their needs.
That the Church on earth will ever keep to its evangelical mission of making disciples of all the nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of the world will ensure that people in all countries will be free to practice their faith without fear of discrimination or retribution. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That no one will be so attached to this earth as to regret being called to eternal life in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we as Christian people will seek understanding of each other, and that differences will give way to acceptance, dialogue, and friendship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are sick and bereaved may receive healing and acceptance through Christ and the intercession of St. Mary of the Cross. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all our dead may ascend to glory with Christ our Priest and King. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we make these and all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, we offer our sacrifice now in supplication to honour the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. The fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Gregory our Bishop and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them with the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who are pleased to throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Blessed and broken, poured and flowing.
And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who allowed those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, who today ascended to heaven, I invoke your presence. Be with us, give us your protection. And to all those who attend this Mass, give them your protection. Be with those that they love and be with those that they pray for. And I ask for all of you the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Joy in the morning. He give me joy.